there, everybody. It is Tuesday, September 20th, 2011, and I'm just stopping by to say hi again today. I really felt the urge to do a morning video today. Morning, as in Pacific time, quarter to 11 morning. So anyway, this is just a little bit of a new one for me, but it turned out that I was able to do that, and so here I am. And so, let me see, Lord, what should I be talking about today? I guess I could just go over a few thoughts about my morning, and honestly, I try to bring a balance to my friends and followers on Facebook and Twitter world, but I thank God for free speech and that God has given us these tools to use to share our hearts and what's on our minds and, you know, what's our passion about our passion, and I just think that the world really is a better place because of it. I know you have to be careful when you're doing Twitter and Facebook to always protect yourself, you know, in all those ways. And but anyway, I appreciate it. I really appreciate that God has raised up people with the technology to allow us to express ourselves. Remember when we didn't have Twitter? I mean, there's people out there that don't know what we're talking about. They don't have a clue, and they probably go, what in the heck is that? And why are people so into it and stuff like that? So I guess if you're not into it, you just don't know and you don't understand. But it's to me, a place where I can share what's on my heart and with other people, a lot of people that are like-minded. So I just want to encourage you, though, to be encouraged today with whatever it is you're doing in your life. And last night I thought, oh, okay, this is enough politics. So I decided to share a few videos from dance, the ballet, modern dance and stuff. So I put a few videos on there from YouTube of Center Stage is a really good dance movie, really modern ballet, you might say. And I just love the dancing in that movie. So anyway, this morning I woke up to just the news and stuff, and I flipped it back. I'm going to try to not be so narrow-minded on things. I was flipping it back and forth from CNN to Fox News, and Rick Perry was on both channels at the UN talking about Israel and stuff. So I was thinking that was really good. And then I flipped it back over to Fox News, and they had they turned it off before he was finished speaking. And I thought, well, I just, you know, I didn't approve of that. So I tweeted him and stuff, because I thought, well, this was their moment to keep it going, to hear what he had to say, to defend Israel and to stand up at the UN. They're there to try to get trying to get into the UN or something, a Palestinian state or something like that. But I don't know the details. But anyway, so gosh, I just think it was just my deal was is I just think it was really, really neat that Rick Perry was there. He took advantage of the moment he could be there as a presidential candidate, and that was, to me, that was leadership. And I really like that kind of leadership where he spoke truth for Israel, And in those moments where somebody's speaking truth about something, we should try to take advantage and capture the moment. And that's why I was just a little bit like, I'm going, look, CNN still has it on. They were still allowing us to watch his speech. And I was trying to be careful to go, well, you know, they're fair and balanced, blah, blah, blah. But I think they're cashing in on the Tea Party. I think they're cashing in on the conservative movement. I mean, they have a guy over there, I forget his name, but he's from The Blaze, and he's a CNN contributor now, and he was speaking for the conservative side. And so I thought that was really, really cool, you know. I mean, you know, look, God is no respecter of persons or networks. If there's a network, I'm just telling you how things work. I don't know. I don't speak as an authority or anything on anything, really, but except the Word of God and prayer when I'm in that mode. So what I'm saying is Fox News, you know, they've got a little bit of a challenge on their hands now. If they don't play their cards right, so to speak, they're going to lose some conservative watchers, some viewers, because, you know, I do notice, and if you're listening, Fox News, if you ever tune into my videos, which would be probably a miracle, but what I'm saying is, you know, I see there's some political correctness of your own on there, and if you're not careful, you know, I mean, you had a lady on there, I forget her name this morning, she was endorsing that Palestinians have a state. And you guys probably already knew her views, but you put her on anyway. Well, that's okay, but what are the true views that we're supposed to be rooting here for? This is really critical in the eyes of God, that we really stand up for Israel. Okay? I mean, we are tight with Israel, that we stay tight with Israel, because that's God's land that he gave to the Jews. Okay, that's Israel. Their name was Israel all through the Bible. Israel. Okay, the children of Israel. Israel. And so, okay, I'm going to get off this subject onto something else. What else, Lord? I just pray right now, Father, over America. I pray over America, Lord God. I pray over the world, Lord. There's going to come a time and a day where the trumpets will blow, and we're going to go with you in the rapture, or you're going to come back. I don't know how it's all going to work, but all I'm saying is we should be ready to meet Jesus. So, if you're not a Christian, you don't understand why we Christians talk about Jesus so much. But once you become a Christian, you'll understand, you'll know, and you'll feel the burden of the guilt of sin taken off of you, so much so that you're going to want to shout from the rooftops. I mean, you're going to make a maniac after out of yourself, so to speak. Everybody that has come to Jesus knows what I'm talking about. You almost just make a fool of yourself because you're just so excited about Jesus. He's forgiven you for all of your sins and all that guilt and all that guilt. You guys don't understand how much guilt you're carrying around. And you fight it off. You try to save yourself by the way you eat. I'm not saying not eat healthy. But I know I can talk about that because I used to be there, okay? I tried to save myself by the way I ate. If I ate pure foods and if I ate whole grains from the health food store, you know, etc. That's a form of trying to save yourself, okay? Now, God does want us to eat healthy. Oh, don't get me wrong. But salvation is only comes from Jesus. That guilt can only be taken away by Jesus and by the blood of Jesus, what he did on the cross. And it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. God is a God of mercy, but he bring us, those of us that know him for a long time and that are closer to him, so to speak. He's as close to you as he is to me, but I might be closer than some because of the way I seek him. So, in my heart, not in the outward, not how much I go to church or anything like that. It's not about religion. He knows our hearts and he knows your heart. You could be the most vilest sinner on earth and he's looking at your heart and going, I love you. I mean, I saw somebody post a comment at Facebook today after a brother was talking about Jesus and shared, put a posting of the word on there. And the woman says, I'm not into God or something like that, you know. And that was fine if she is expressing herself. But then, you know, how Facebook keeps flowing and flowing and flowing. It got away from me. I was going to say, you might not be into God, but he's into you. He really does love you. And so anyway, Father, just continue to touch the people out there and draw them to Jesus, Lord. Touch our troops today, God. I just thank you for this day. This is the day that you have made, Lord, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. And, oh, Lord, I thank you for your mercy. Help us focus on what we need to focus on today, Lord, and get done what we need to get done. Open doors that no man can close, and close all the wrong doors that no man can reopen. People need miracles, Lord. People need finances. People need jobs, God. And I thank you, Father God, for opening the door for them to get those jobs they need. The economy, Lord God, of the world and in America, if you should tarry, Lord, Father, hold us up. Hold us up, Lord God. And I thank you, Father God. We love you and give you all the praise and glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I wanted to share just a little bit of something that I have learned over the years that I don't know if you know this or not, but a church is a non-profit organization automatically. Now you can look into the 503c thing, but it's, as far as I know, and I'm not an attorney, it is already, a church is already non-profit, okay? The reason most people file for non-profit status is because they like to have the proof for the donors and for the government, etc. And there's nothing wrong with that, of course. But I just wanted to share that with you. You might want to look into that further if you ever do something like have a church. Also, the Postal Service will not allow you to do bulk mailings at the nonprofit level if you don't have nonprofit status with the government. So that's one reason also. But now we have the internet and stuff. A lot of mailings, churches have moved from too many mailings, actually, in the mail to doing a lot of their work online, basically, in my opinion. And I'm just throwing that in there. I don't know. I just get on here. I really like to just get on here and talk without a script. Nothing wrong with a script, because I know I'm going to be using scripts to do some videos, but not for me, but for others. And sometimes I say, well, I go better buy a script. But anyway, for me, I'm just, whatever your interest is in life, like, okay, I have an interest right now in my life to do social networking in whatever I do. And it's my heart and soul almost. Sometimes I can get carried away, I think, maybe too much. But we have freedom to be interested in what we want to be interested in. I'm interested in politics now also. And I, 10 years ago, 5 years ago, I couldn't have said that about my life. I never knew I would be into politics like I am now. But not, and I have so much more to learn also. So, but you can, you know, go with your passion, you know. Also, I wanted to say a few words about amnesty for Obama voters. It almost sounds like a joke, but really when you think about it, I think there's a lot of voters out there that have buyer's remorse, as you've maybe heard that line. So I think we need to give the Obama voters amnesty. If you want to come over to the other side, you can, freely, without being punished. And also, I wanted to bring this up, this one more point up, is that when you have a nonprofit status for a church, they say, I think, that you're not, you can't endorse one particular candidate, okay? That's as far as I know, that's what the big deal is about keeping your nonprofit status. So in my opinion, and I know there's Democrats and Republicans and independents and all kinds of people that go to churches, but that doesn't, in my opinion, it doesn't, shouldn't stop you from being political, as in talking about our country and the way we want our country to go in this world. If you can't endorse somebody, which I don't totally endorse anybody in particular right now, I'm still favoring Rick Perry, you know, and up until the day I vote, that's the way I'm probably going to be because, well, I don't know what I'll be tomorrow. But you know what I'm saying? If churches feel led to talk about all the candidates or just in the way our country should be moving, I don't understand why you should let the, as long as you don't endorse one particular candidate, okay? And there's ways of doing things like, there's ways of doing things, okay, without endorsing one particular candidate. You can talk about how you don't like one particular candidate, you know what I mean? And that would be like, okay, people can form in their minds a process of elimination. Not that you're trying to sway anybody on their vote. That's what I think also it talks about. I'm just talking about there's nothing wrong with a church talking about values in America. And we're not trying to put our Christian values on the world or America. But you can thank God for our values because it's part of the salvation of America. We're going to keep preaching the gospel. That's why God has blessed our country so greatly. We've got such great military, people that love our country that will fight for it and to keep us safe. That makes us great. We are an exceptional nation. We are, okay? And even if we just say it, we are, that makes us, we are, okay? We are an exceptional nation. I used to have a different view about things. Like I think, oh, well, gosh, another country could be exceptional also. Well, yeah, if they want to be exceptional, they can be exceptional. God loves the whole world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have eternal life. But if I'm not faithful to America, it's like I'm for the Chargers, okay? Because I live in San Diego and our team is the Chargers. I'm for the Chargers. The Chargers are exceptional, okay? Now, they might lose games and not be able to go to the Super Bowl, blah, blah, blah. But I'm going to be faithful to them up until the very end and beyond. And so there's nothing wrong with being faithful to being a patriotic America and saying it's exceptional, because we are, okay? We are a nation of freedoms, the greatest nation in the whole entire world of freedoms, okay? People love us. They want to come here. They want a part of the pie, okay, when they come here. But come here legally. Don't try to come here illegally. And when you come here, learn how to speak English. You know, when you come here, go ahead and have your own culture. But don't overtake us with Sharia law. Don't even go there. Okay, we'll fight that tooth and nail. You don't come over here and use our system against us either, okay? If you want to come to America, you're going to have to behave yourself. Do you understand? Don't come over here and just think you can come over and run our lives and run our country. When I lived in downtown San Diego, we had people from India, God bless them, that ran businesses down there. And they almost acted like snooty, like we're from India and we are managers, and so you American peons, you know, we're going to look down on you. Please, that's insulting. I mean, honest to God, that was the attitude. And because you think you can come over here and take advantage of our freedoms and then get this big, arrogant attitude towards us. And there's illegal aliens, illegals, that come in here and do the same thing, because they know our system and they take advantage of it. But in prayer, I come against it in the name of Jesus. I come against that attitude. I also come against Islamic jihad ideology in the name of Jesus. I just thank you, Father God, for saving our country from going under. I thank you for saving us from hitting that iceberg and sinking. And I pray that every leader of America, including President Obama, would be humble himself under the mighty hand of God, whether he really knows you or not, Lord Jesus, that you would stop him in his tracks from ruining America, that you would stop him in his tracks from putting one more dent in America's foundation. Stop him, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father God, economically, his policies stink. Lord God Almighty, I'm asking you to wake America up in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God, for those that voted for Obama that are sorry, that they will repent in a way. I'm not talking bad about them, Lord God. I voted for Al Gore. I'm not telling them how to vote. I'm just saying, God, wake them up politically. Wake them up spiritually. Thank you for this video, Lord. Thank you, God Almighty, for our day. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And we give you all the praise and glory. We plead the blood of Jesus over our children, over our friends, family, and loved ones, over our country, over our troops. We thank you, Father God, for this day. Bless us and make us a blessing, and establish your covenant in this earth through us, Father. In the name of Jesus, we give you all the praise and glory. Amen. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you for tuning in. Even if you don't agree with me, thank you for your comments. I love you, and God loves you, and God bless America. Bye-bye.